Hello and welcome to the release of Digital Anarchy's Transcriptive 1.1 update. My name's Evan, and I'm going to go over some new features that we've added to Transcriptive. Normally, we wouldn't release such a video for updates, but this time around we've added a lot of new features that really change the functionality and workflow of Transcriptive. So without further delay, let's jump into it. First off, we've added an entirely new panel called PowerSearch. Like Transcriptive, you'll find this panel under Windows Extension PowerSearch. And right here, you'll see that PowerSearch is loading all the metadata from your project. What PowerSearch allows you to do is search your entire project for words or phrases. So let's go ahead and do sales team. Here you'll see it has returned both sequences and clips that include the terms sales and team. So let's go ahead and if we select the sequence right here, notice it says sales team. Notice the time code right here, 8 seconds and 23 frames. So let's go ahead and open it. And there we go, it opens. You'll see that the playhead then jumps to 8 seconds and 23 in your timeline. And it matches up here, so that's great. The next big added feature or improvement is that we've now added auto-loading of transcripts. In our previous release, you had to manually load your transcript from speech analysis. Now Transcriptive will automatically load it for you. This is great for when you're switching back and forth between sequences. So no longer must we ask for a new transcript, discard, load transcript, it's all done for you. After that, a great new feature would be our find and replace function. No longer will you have to change the same incorrect word over and over throughout your hour-long transcript. For example, let's take this short corporate recruiting video. Now, I know that the name of this company was MemSQL, which is tech jargon for Memory Structured Query Language. But as you see here, Speechmatics returned MemSQL.
Drawn to MemSQL because they're...
Now, that's not correct, though I'll say Speechmatics actually did a pretty good job considering. So let's go ahead and change this. I'm going to select replace, type in the incorrect word, SQL. You'll see that Transcriptive has found 5 instances of SQL. And then over here, I will type in the correction, MemSQL. Now, we have 2 options from here. We have the ability to replace one by one, and you'll notice that the number of SQL instances are lowering as we replace the word. The second option is to go ahead and simply replace all. Now, once you do this, you cannot undo it, so make sure you want to do it. This will, as you guess, replace all of the instances. Now, you may or may not have already noticed the slight change in our search UX. We went ahead and changed that ugly green highlight to this red dotted outline and cream colored background. Who doesn't like a new paint job? You can also now simply use Tab and Shift Tab to cycle through your search results. So let's now talk about a few new UI additions. As you can see here, this little guy is Sync with Playhead. This has been a feature request for some time. What this does is that wherever you find yourself in your timeline, you can now sync the transcript to where you are in your sequence. So that's cool. Also, here we've added an additional playback speed option. You can now playback at 200%.
Bring in now are the future leaders of our company, so we need individuals that are interested in their own career growth as well as helping build a great company.
If you notice here, you can now delete entire lines at a time. This is helpful if you want to get rid of, say, that pesky cameraman in the background. Also, let me draw your attention right over here in the timecode column. You'll see now that we list the clip name that this particular portion of transcript is from. Another new feature is the ability to group a single speaker by paragraph rather than individual sentences. Originally, if you only had a single speaker in your clip and you declined to identify speaker when requesting a transcript, your transcript would come back transcribed in sentences rather than one continuous paragraph. This isn't simply an aesthetic feature, but this allows for your single speaker paper transcript to be formatted in paragraphs rather than a series of sentences, which is nice for readability. And that leads me directly into our last feature of note, the ability to export paper transcripts as RTFs, or rich text formats. RTFs will allow for more advanced formatting options than the previous plain text, and will also retain its formatting when opening up in various programs. The RTF exporter is still a bit buggy, but it's loads better than the plain text option we had before. But we hope to have that updated shortly. And I almost forgot, actually, one last feature. We now support proxy servers. So for those of you on networks with tight security, which include maybe governments or large companies, we now allow your IT department to set up Transcriptive with a proxy server. If Transcriptive has trouble getting an internet connection, setting this up should help. Your IT department should know how to do it. And that about wraps it up for Transcriptive 1.1 features. If you want to try Transcriptive out for yourself, you can go to digitalanarchy.com where you can download a demo. While you're there, you can also check out our special effects plugins, Beautybox, Flicker Free, and Samurai Sharpen. Again, my name is Evan, and I'm Software QA and Tech Support here at Digital Anarchy, and I hope you have a great day.